Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the data analytics training program, which we are trying to learn by using Microsoft Excel. And this is our session number 6. So I like to welcome again on this auspicious day of Sunday. Okay, so guys, this is our sixth session. And in this sixth session, we'll continue discussion. So before the break, I discussed about how we can work on passwords whenever we discuss while working on Microsoft Office Excel. So passwords plays very significant role. So in case if password is there, you want to remove the password from the workbook, what you can do, you can go to File, go to Info. Here you can see if the password is protected, it will show you Protect Pass, like you can see Protect Workbook. So you can click on Unprotect. Here you can see click on encrypt with password, put the password. Okay, once you're done with this, then you can go there and you can just remove the password, press OK. Okay, then you remove the password, press OK, and then you just do Control S. Okay, then I'll close this. Okay, then two passwords were there in that. So I hope that Ini's first password will not work when I'll open that. So now you can see that first password did not work. This is the second password which I did by using programming. So two ways you can put a password. So one way to put password, I told you that you can simply go to Info. And then you can do Protect Workbook. And here you can put Encrypt with Password. Okay, here. And you can put a password here. And then it will be password protected. Okay. So it is password. Then you can do Control S. The other way I told you to write a program, go to Developer tab. If you go to Developer tab, under Developer tab, go to Visual Basic. And under Visual Basic, I told you go to this workbook, click on this workbook. When you go to this workbook, here General will come. So click on Workbook from here. Okay, and then you write the program, what program to write. So this is a program what you need to write. Clear, everyone? Anyone, any doubt? We have done this before the break. Now, whenever I open this workbook, it should say good morning to me or good afternoon. So something, it should say hello, hi Amit, welcome again to work on MS Excel whenever I open. And when I'll close, then it should say thank you Amit for giving your great time on to me on MS Excel. So I hope to see you again, something like that. I want Excel to feel thankful to me that I have spent my time on Excel. Instead of spending my time on Insta or FB, I have spent my time on Excel. So I want Excel to feel thankful for me. So what I can do, I can write a program for that. So Alt DL, so not Alt DL, so probably you can do Alt F11. So you do Alt F11. So if I go under Alt F11, go under Insert. Under Insert, click on Module. Under Insert, click under Module and write Sub, S-U-B, Sub, everything, all the VBA programming, what we write in Excel, we'll start with Sub space. So I'll write Auto underscore open. Open bracket, close bracket, sub space file name, auto underscore open, open bracket, close bracket, you do that. So then I write a message box. I'll write a message, MSG, message box, under double quote, I'll write something. So whenever this, I'll open the Excel, it should give me a message. Welcome Amit to MS Excel. Workbook Okay, something like this. So this is the program I wrote. Then the next program I want that when I'll close, when I'm closing it, it should say thank you to me. So I'll write sub under auto underscore close, open bracket, close bracket, message box, MSGBOX. Write some message, whatever you feel. Okay, I hate you, I kill you. So anything you want to write, you can write there. So message box, thank you, Amit. Thank you, Amit, for your valuable time. For your valuable time. So thank you, Amit, for your valuable time. Open and then double quotes. Okay, done with this. So you can see that. You can see that message. You can see this, run this. Yeah. So once you're done with this, Alt Q, then Alt S, sorry, Control S. You close this, you save it, and then if I'm closing this, okay, so it goes like that way only. Why do not show me the that message? Let me open it, check. Okay, this was no. Did I open which one? One minute, guys. Welcome everyone to you. So I wrote where this one or this one I wrote. One minute. I'll write again. So just again, I'll just confirm this. So I'll do it again, guys. I hope you'll not mind. So I'll go to Visual Basic. Yeah, I've written no. Then insert module. Then again, I'm writing. I hope you don't mind. Sub auto underscore open. Then message box, MSGBOX message box. Welcome, Amit, to MS Excel. Okay. So then sub auto underscore close, open bracket, close bracket, message box, MSG. This was MSG message box, MSGBOX. Thank you, Amit. Thank you, Amit. See you again. And then let me just copy this. Copy that. Okay. Then Alt Q. Okay. Then Control S. Control S. Two time I did Control S. Okay. Then see, I'm trying to close it. So it's showing me. Thank you, Amit. See you again. I say, okay. And then it got closed. And then if I try to open this workbook again, so if I'm opening this workbook again, so it is asking me password 123. I put the password. Then again, this is password 123. I'll put. Then it's showing that message. You remember I write the program, welcome everyone to MS Excel tutorial. Then it's showing welcome Amit to MS Excel. I said okay. And then I did my work. If I'm trying to close, showing me thank you, Amit. See you again. You understood, right? Anyone, any doubt? Alt F4, if I want to open that again, book one, Alt F4. If I want to open that again, Alt F4. So if you see this, developer, Visual Basic, you can see this program, what I wrote. Control C. New. Can you see this, everyone? Clear, anyone, any doubt? Yeah, Vinay, I've shown you the programming. So you can write that message, anything, guys. No need to write welcome Amit there. Thank you, Amit there. Don't write that. Otherwise, your Excel will get angry on you. Put your name. So I hope you people are liking this. I hope this is interesting for you people. Anyone, any doubt, please ask me, guys. Any question, any doubt, any concern. So I hope you understood this, guys. Okay. Now, talking about age calculation and all, we did already. Now, few like general thing, if I say, you remember yesterday, we discussed about putting unique entries. I hope you remember putting unique entries. So duplicate values, if there. You can check the duplicate values if you have some values, like if you have some names are like this. I want to check that any name is duplicated or not, any duplicate values there. So if you want to check that, so now see this, before I do that duplicate thing, these are colored, this Raghuram, all that are colored. I want to remove their color. So what you do, just select this, then Alt H. Then you go to fill. You'll go to FFI fill. There, can you see? No. Yeah, go down, not fill. Go down, go to here, do clear format. Okay, do this clear format. Clear all. If you do, everything get deleted. So I don't want clear format. Clear Control Z. Okay, clear format. Okay. Now if there are you, what happened? Why Raghuram Rajan came everywhere? Yeah, so just do that, just clear format. You do that, the format. Okay, now, guys, if you see this now, it just names, few are in bold, few are normal. How to make bold, unbold? Control B. These names, these fonts are different, guys. You can see these fonts are different. So this font, whatever this font, this is Calibri 12. And you see this is Arial Black 12. So what I'll do, just click on this cell, click on Format Painter and just select this. Now their font will become same. Can you get this, guys? You want everything. Suppose this is the cell, okay. I did something with this cell. I made it 18, okay. I made it blue. Okay. I did something with this cell. Whatever I did, I want it to be repeated on everything. So what I'll do, I'll just click, put my cursor on that cell, put Format Painter, click on Format Painter. And then you select wherever you want, you select the data and you just remove that. It will happen like that. Can you understand this? Format Painter is like that. Control Z if I want to undo this. I did for you, just to show you. Clear, everyone? Format Painter, have you understood? Okay, great. Fine. So you remember, no? Last class I was talking about putting unique entries. Last class I was talking about putting unique entries, serial number, and suppose name of the student. So name of the student. So here I'll just write serial number 1, 2. So if 30 students are there, something like this. Okay, if 30 students are there, something like this. So I don't have to write 30 together. Select 1 and 2, and then you can drag it. Then you can drag it. 1 minute here. Oh, so my mouse is not very. So drag it. You can do it like this. Remember, right? So you can do this. So you will get 30 numbers. Okay, you will get 30 numbers like this. Okay. And that is the one way to do that. Other way, I told you, just write one number. I told you, write one number. Let me just increase the font size. Write one number and then you go to home, you go to fill, then you go to series. If you want vertically, click on column, stop, step value 1, stop value 30, you do, you will get the number. Okay, then I told you, like suppose here you're writing name. Some name like Amit Singh, some name you're writing, then Virat Kohli. So you write some name. You want to make sure that the only unique entry will be entered. Okay, you remember, right? This is very important. Only unique entries to be added. Remember, if you remember, right? Only, yeah, Rajendra, you're telling me something. So if you want only unique entry to be entered, you remember last class I did that for you. So we did that again, just doing it. So what you'll do, you select the cell where you want the unique entry. Do data validation, Alt DL. You'll, otherwise you go to data. Under data, you will find data validation, Alt DL. Allow, in allow, what you do, click on custom. And here you write the formula equal to count if open bracket equal to count if open bracket. Then select the cell. Okay, select the cell where you want. Select the cell. Press F4 key. F4 means like dollar sign. Can you see the dollar? F4, what the F4 key will do? F4 key will fix the cell. So F4 key will fix the cell. F4 key, F4, or put dollar sign, shift 4 before and after, comma, click on the first cell, B4. You remember we did all this yesterday. Then less than 2. If you write this function, what this function will do, this function will make sure that you put unique entries only. You should not put any entry which is duplicated. You should put unique entry only. So this is a function for that. Clear, everyone? Press OK. So then if you want some alert, you can put a warning, duplicate value. You can put an input message, please put unique name, something like this. Press OK. And then you can put any name. Okay. So now, yesterday I did something called upper. So if you do upper, with upper, you'll get everything in capital letter. So upper, you'll get everything in capital letter. So you see, so upper equal to upper. So this is considering it's a formula. Okay, no problem. You simply write it now. You can write with capital letter. So you can write that. One minute, my phone is error in that. Yeah. then because I put equal to sign, so this is character, so you don't have to put equal to sign, because equal to sign means it considers as a quantitative data. So that's why it's showing that. Okay, then you simply, you know how you can simply put some name. If I put any name which you know that it will show me error, you know that. So you understood this, right? So this way you know this very well. Now this is the one, this is the way to where you write a unique characters. Now similarly, if I have to write your roll number, so roll number, I want the same thing for roll number. I want the unique values for the roll number. So imagine I want the roll number. Okay, so if I have to put roll number, then roll number, if I put, like if I say here, if I select these values like this, simply I'm just selecting few values. So because I want to do it fast, I don't want to take more time on this. I don't know many of you liking or not liking, so I'll not spend more time. So click on custom. If I say equal to count if, then open bracket, select the cells, F4 key, press F4, it will fix the cell, comma, write the first cell C4, then close bracket, less than 2. Then what it will do here, here I can put unique values. I can put unique value here. If I write 2, 3, 4, 4, not accept, okay, because it's not unique value. But the problem is that if I'm writing roll number, how can I make sure that the other person write only numbers? If the other person write DF, it's a unique. Other person write TYU, it's a unique. So then how will you restrict that the person can write only numbers? To restrict that the person should write only numbers, and that to be unique numbers. So what you can do, select the cell, again, all DL, select the cell, all DL, and there custom in formula, write equal to and, again, count if, select the cell where you want to apply. You want to apply this. Okay. Fix the cell F4, comma, first cell is D4, close bracket, less than 2. Okay. Comma. Then you write is number, open bracket, write the first cell D4. And then press OK. Now, if you see here, guys, here I put that number. If I write character, not accept that. It only accept number. You put number. It will not accept character. Can you understand this? So what function I wrote? So do alt DL means data validation. Go inside data validation. In that, write equal to and. This function, guys, and or, I think you understand, and function means both, all the conditions should satisfy, or means either of conditions can satisfy. And then you open bracket, count if, then bracket open, then you select the cell, first cell, whatever is your first cell, you select that, okay, you select that. Whatever range you want to select that. Okay. Comma, the first cell, whatever is your first cell. Okay. Then what you do, this less than 2, because the value should be less than 2. Value is what you're entering. The count, if you understand, it's counting it. So the counting, it should be less than 2. So it's either 0 or 1. Either you don't put, either max, you cannot put anything more than one, then count if you understood this, and then comma, then write is number bracket D4, your first cell, put two bracket, enter. Any doubt, anyone? Any doubt? You want to see that function? I'll show you, right? See this. Anyone, any doubt, any question? Clear, everyone? Why others are not responding? Only 1 or 2% respond. Whatever I ask, only 1 or 2% respond. What about others? Akriti, are you there? Abhishek Gowda, are you there? Amrita? Chandan? Uja Egde, Divya? Lakshmi, are you there? Guys, please respond also, no? Don't tell me that you people don't like chatting and all. You can write here. Okay. Divya, yeah, you are responding. भूमिका, यू आर देयर, आई नो यू आर देयर, यू आर वेरी सिंसियर स्टूडेंट. लक्ष्मी, फाइनली लक्ष्मी रेस्पॉन्डेड. थैंक यू लक्ष्मी फॉर रेस्पॉन्डिंग. विजयदशमी, एनी डाउट? ओके फाइन. सो आई होप यू पीपल अंडरस्टूड दिस. सो देन गाइस, सपोज सिंपली आई एम टेलिंग, सपोज यू आर पुटिंग फोन नंबर हेयर. ओके, यू आर पुटिंग फोन नंबर हेयर. And what you want, you know that if you put a phone number of India STD code, so with ISD, you know that +91 should come. No? With every Indian telephone number, +91 should come. So what you can do, guys, you can select this cell. You can select this cell, then control one, go to custom, select this cell, then format cell, control one, custom, under general, write +91, space 10 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Put 10 zeros, press OK. Now, if you put any phone number here, like my number 991677967, okay, 3 something, I write my phone number, I press enter, you can see plus, it came with +91. Can you understand this? So any number, you put any number, 8973541234567891010. Enter. So it came with +91. Can you understand this? So now I want to put random numbers. Okay, I want to put random phone numbers. So what I can do, I can select this cell. I put equal to rand between. So what rand between will do, it will generate a random number. It will generate a random number between what? So 999345678910, comma 992345678910. So it will generate a 10-digit number because I want to put phone number, no, to show you. So I want to put phone number to show you. Either what I can do, I can ask your phone number. Hey, give me your phone number, yaar. I want to write. So either I can do that, but because I'm doing recording of the class, so I don't want to give any real phone numbers of anyone. So that's why I just want to put some dummy random numbers. So here, if I use the command rand between, it will generate the random number. So I don't have to do that work. So in Excel, whenever you have to put random numbers, okay, so in probability and other chapters. So whenever we do risk analysis, we use, nowadays we follow something called Monte Carlo simulation to analyze stock or to work on any form of statistical risk management technique. We work on probability. So you can generate random numbers. So random numbers, simply it will get generated, keep on generating. If I write anything here, you can see this number will change. If I change, right, these numbers will change. They will change. I hope you're understanding. The random numbers, simply they came. So because I put a condition. So if you put a condition called rand between. So rand between, it will ask you rand between, random number. It will generate a random number. So it has generated random number. So I gave, so it will get generated. Clear, everyone? So the same thing you can do here. Data. And here data analysis, under that, if you see, under that you have something called random number generation. Can you see random number generation? So all this purpose, when we do advanced statistical analysis, we try to work on a lot of data. We try to create all possible scenarios, okay, multiple scenarios like stock market. So how they determine impact cost in stock market. So they create 16 scenarios. So price increase by 1/3, volume remain constant. Price increase by 2/3, volume remain constant. Price decrease by 1/3, volume remain constant. Like that, 16 scenarios are being created and each scenario are being put weight. So I don't want to get into technical part of all that. So random numbers are something which is very common, very important. So whenever I want to do some statistical probability based questions or something which is uncertain scenario, so we basically work on random numbers. So this is the way. So you can generate random number by using the command called randbetween. Okay, so everyone understood this, right? Anyone, any doubt? Yeah, so how I did Kanchana. What you do, Kanchana, for all the cells, no, for which you want +91 to should come, you select the cell, Kanchana, then you do control 1 or format cell. So format cell, right click on mouse, do format cell or control 1, and then go to custom, Kanchana, then go to custom. Under custom, you see general. So just erase that general and then write +91 space. Put 10 zeros, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10. Put 10 zeros, press OK. So now, if you put any number, if I put any number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If I put any 10 digit number, it will automatically will come with +91. What happens, Sonika? No doubt, no? So whenever, see, random number, there's a random number. So, okay. So I hope you people are understanding random numbers. Okay, so random numbers like here, so these are the student name. So these are the student. So this is the mark sheet. Okay, this is the mark sheet. They got some marks. No? They got in this subject. They got some marks. So around how many subjects are there? So around 16 subjects are there, and they got some marks. So some dummy numbers I want to put, guys. Okay, that number doesn't mean much for me. Why I want to put that number? Simply for showing you people, for showing that calculation to you people. I just want to put some dummy number. Now, Bhagwan, are you there? Bhagwan, are you there? Respond me if you are there. So Bhagwan, now see freeze pan. So what I want, guys, some students were there in the class, around 30 students are there. I can see those 30 students, put filter all DFF. So if not coming, you can put a filter is coming up because of those, this data is there, no? So Excel is not understanding where to put filter. All DFF. Data is there somewhere at the top. Leave that part. So you just see this. Around 30 students are there. What I want, guys, I want to put a marks to them. Okay. Some dummy marks. Okay. So why are you putting this thing? Because I want to teach you some statistical functions. So for that, I need some dummy numbers. Okay, sir. What is the big thing, sir? I can put some dummy number, 56, 89, 42, something I can put. But imagine if you start putting this number, how much time it will take? 16 subject into 30 point, 480 numbers you have to put. So why should you waste your time? Do one thing, use the function randbetween. And if you use the function randbetween, put rand between 0, 100. So if you do this now, you will generate a random number between 0 to 100. Okay, great, I got that. So I'll copy this. I'll go down. Okay, and till here. I think till here the students are there. Now what I'll do? I copied that shift. I press the shift. Then I'll go right hand side. I'll see till where the subject names are there. Till here subject names are there. So I do control V. So, but if you guys imagine if there's no number, imagine here because something is written. So we got the hint, no? Something was written. That's why we got the hint. Imagine if nothing would be there. If I do clear all, imagine if nothing is there. And if you simply copy this control C and then you went till down. Bhagwan, I hope you are listening to me. So then if I go this, if I ask you till where I need to go, guys, I'm not sure where I need to go. Till where I need to go, guys. Right hand side till where I need to go, I have no idea. So under that scenario, no, what I can do, I'll put my cursor here and I'll go to view. I'll go to view under view freeze pans. If you do freeze pan, Bhagwan, then you see wherever you go right hand side, you see that name of student and gender column got fixed. Did you get it? So that is very helpful for me when I take attendance and all. So that become very helpful to me. Alt shortcut key is Alt WFF. So what I can do, I'll copy this control C, that ran between command. I copy that and then I'll go down. Then the last subject is genetics, control V. So guys, you see this, no, ran between. So what ran between command basically did, guys, what ran between command did for me. So I don't had to do that work manually. So that I use that function ran between and I wrote equal to ran between 0, 100. So when I use that function equal to ran between 0, 100, so it randomly generated the number between 0 to 100. Okay, so, and because I was not looking for some real value, I'm looking for some random values. I got those random values. Okay. Did you understand this? Yeah, so, but guys, the problem with this random number, na, the problem with this random number is that these random numbers, no, they'll keep on changing. You see that, no, you do anything, they will keep on changing. The problem with this random number, they will keep on changing. So you cannot do it. I cannot teach you anything. I hope you're understanding. So I cannot do any mathematical calculation on this, because if I teach anything now, next time if I do anything, it will get changed. So if I do sum here, I selected this cell, close bracket, enter. Okay, and then I did sum. Then it gets changed. Are you understanding? If I try to find the average of this, it will get changed. So I hope you're understanding what I'm trying to teach you. The problem with this random number is that they will keep on changing. Every time they'll keep on changing. So now you wanted the random number between 0 to 100, you got. Yeah, I got, sir. I'm very happy. But again, this keeps on changing. If I want to teach something, that this is the value. So this can be concluded. But next time when I see, it got changed. So you say, you'll start laughing. Hey, sir, what you're teaching, sir? Whatever you're putting, getting changed only, sir. What is happening, sir? So what we can do, guys, so you got the random number. No, yes, sir, I got the random number. You got the random number. Yes, sir, I got. So once you get this, remove the formula, guys. Can you understand, guys? All these cells are formula, no? Are you getting me? All these cells, what you see, so all these cells, guys, what you see, they are basically a formula. I hope if you can understand with me. One nimsha, guys. So if you understand, if all these are formulas, no? Okay, all are with me, all are understanding what I'm doing. You have not went to any other world, right? You are still in my world. Okay, so all are with me, right? So all are these formulas, no, guys? So all are these formula, guys. So what you can do, guys, remove the formula. Please don't forget this. In interview, you will get a question. How to remove the formula from the cell? How will you remove the formula, guys? Very simple. A shortcut key, if you want, I'll tell you the shortcut. And I'll do step by step also. Shortcut is Control C, and then Alt, remove your key, Alt, then E, then S, then V. This is a shortcut key, or manually also I'll teach you. Copy that, Control C, copy that. Then after you copy that, then go to Home, under Home, go to Paste, click on Paste Value. So formula will get removed. If you want together, you want shortcut like this. So Control C, Alt E S V. Formula will get removed. Any doubt, anyone? Any question, anyone? Any doubt, any concern? So now the same thing I can apply it everywhere. Control shift right arrow, Control shift right arrow, select everything. Control down, Control shift right arrow, Control down. I selected everything. Control C for copy, Alt E S V for paste. Control C for copy, Alt ESV for paste. Alt ESV, Rajendra, Alt ESV. So Alt ES will save. So what happened? No, if you do Control C, I'll show you guys. If you see Control C, then Alt ES. So it will open Paste Special. Alt ES will open Paste Special, and there click on Value. Value is for removing the formula. Clear, everyone? Anyone, any doubt, any question? The other way to put random numbers, random numbers, you can put random numbers other way. You can put random numbers other way, guys. You can put all WFF. The other way you can put random number by using the function called equal to rand open bracket close bracket. So if you use this function equal to rand open bracket close bracket, it will generate a random number between 0 to 1. Very powerful tool, equal to rand. normally we use this in probability, probability, because probability always give a random number between 0 to 1. It will generate a random number between 0 to 1. It will generate a random number between 0 to 1. Between 0 to 1, this will generate a random number. Now the question can come in your mind that, sir, one question, sir. I said, please tell me, sir, what is your question? He'll say, sir, this rand equal to rand, open bracket, close bracket, sir, it will give a number between 0 to 1. I said, yes. You'll say, sir, I understood, sir. But my question is that, sir, when we put marks, we put a mark between 0 to 100, sir, not between 0 to 1. So I'll say, okay, no problem. You multiply this with 100 into 100. So if you do that, you will get a number between 0 to 100. Clear, everyone? Any doubt, anyone? Any doubt, anyone? Artha Aita? Any doubt? Ali? Naren? Any doubt? Tasaduk? Triveni? Uday? Any question? Sushma? Lakshmi, any question? Gautam, your friend has went away. Tell your friend to rejoin if your friend want attendance. Okay. Clear, guys. So now I hope you understood this. Okay. Now the next question can come in your mind. I can read your mind, guys. So the next question which can come in your mind, guys, is that, sir, what you did, I understood, sir. You multiplied by 100. I'm highly appreciated with your effort. But sir, I have a question. I say, yeah, please ask me, what is your question? You'll say, sir, tell me one thing. If you give marks to anyone, will you give marks like 15.121728? Sir, have you ever saw someone giving marks like that? I said, yes, correct. You can't give marks like that. So then what we can do, sir? So you can, what you can do, you can use a function called round up, round down. I think you know rounding of digits and all. In basic maths, we are using it. No, same thing we can use here. Round open bracket till how many digits you can round it off. So you can put 0 or 1 or 2, like that many digits it will show you after decimal. So you can spend some time, guys, understanding the difference between round up, round down, round. What is the difference between them? So if I press enter, now I got integer, no decimals. Okay, I'll copy this, control C, then I'll go down, then control V. Clear, everyone? Can you see this, guys? Again, guys, these are having formula. You know how to remove the formula, no? Control C, Alt, ESP. गौतम, आई हैव नथिंग टू स्पीक। नरेंद्र इज देयर? ओके गाइस, सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड। एनी डाउट एनीवन? सो कंचना इज आस्किंग, सर इफ वी हैव टू ऐड फॉर्मूला अगेन, मीन्स कंचना आई डिड नॉट अंडरस्टैंड, इफ वी हैव टू ऐड फॉर्मूला, यू वॉन्ट टू ऐड फॉर्मूला, मीन्स वॉट फॉर्मूला यू वॉन्ट टू ऐड कंचना, फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू वॉन्ट टू स्पीक, बेटा आई एम, यू कैन स्पीक, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी कंचना यू आस्किंग क्वेश्चन। Kanchana, you can speak or you can message, whatever is convenient for you. I'm not actually understood. Anyone else understood Kanchana question? She's asking me. Once we remove format from the cell, can't we add it again? Formula from the cell, can't we add it again? So formula, control Z you can do, Kanchana. That is the only thing. Control Z means only like you go back one, like you did, and then you want, you can do control Z. Otherwise, there's no other way, Kanchana. You can remove formula anytime, Kanchana, but you cannot add formula. Means for that, you have to do it again, the same process. Or you copy and paste somewhere, that is other thing. I hope you understood, Kanchana. Thank you, Kanchana. I'm very happy you are asking question. Kanchana, you are MCOM or I think you are MCOM student, correct? Understood everyone, right? Anyone, any doubt? Redo control Z, yeah, that only I told Shreyas, to her I told, but control Z you can do like next step. Are you getting me? Next step. I did something and I control Z after 10 minutes after doing something. I can't go 4 or 5, like you have to do control Z, control Z, control Z. Like that you can do. But probably after some time that will not work. Control Z is normally, I went one step further, control Z, I come back. That much I can do, not beyond that. Okay, very good, Kanchana. Chalo. So guys, I hope you people are understanding. The other way, guys, one more thing, like when you use this rand, open bracket, close bracket, you did this, no? You copied this, okay? Sir, I forgot, sir, to multiply with 100 and all. So, okay, guys, are you with me? Please pay attention, no, everyone? So Nika is asking, sir, for example, I need to calculate the percentage of student by the unit. Join late, what to do? For example, I need to have percentage student who attended the class, is it? But some student joined late, what to do in that situation? Percentage of student of what, Sonika? Who were present, who were absent, is it? Like this, okay, 1 minute, Sonika, let me do that. Maybe if you're asking me this, let me open the attendance sheet. To Alt-F-O, do Alt-F-O, Alt-F-O. Let me open the attendance sheet of BCA student or something. Attendance sheet, yeah, something. Are you talking about this? Something, yeah. Something like, this is 01. You want to calculate Abhishek Gowda, how much percentage you got. Something like this. So if you want to calculate this, so what is the percentage of class Abhishek Gowda attended? 0 means he is absent, 1 means he is present. Correct, no? So suppose this situation, correct, no? So number of class attended, then total class. Okay, can I do this? Sir, we need to add formula in middle number. Formula in middle number, I am not understanding. Formula in middle number. So you can F2 guys, you can do F2. Whenever you do any formula guys, if any formula you have put something, you want to do any change on this, press F2. And then you go and do whatever changes you want to do here in the formula. You can do that. Now, for example, like, can I do this, guys? Like, suppose few people are there. Okay, some names are there. Just ignore the names and all. Okay, just ignore the names. Okay, so just some classes happened. Or 0 means they're absent, 1 means they're present. I want to find the percentage of attendance. Can I do that? Percentage of attendance. So as such, there is no formula for that. I'll use my common sense. So I'll use my common sense. So Sonika, that same thing I was telling Sonika, if you put any formula, if you want to remove that, if you have removed that formula, you can't get that formula. So only once you can go back. If you went one step further, you want to go back, you can do Control Z, Sonika. You can do Control Z. Control Z will reverse it. You remove the formula, you get it back. Like this is the formula is there, guys. You can see my F2. You can see the formula. So I remove this formula. I remove Control C, Alt ESV. I remove the formula. Now there's no formula. Control Z. So I got the formula. Okay, I got the formula. But if I imagine I do something, then I did something I did. Then maybe after 5-10 minutes, if I want to get back there, so I have to do Control Z that many times. That many times I have to do Control Z. So then if you remember how many steps you went further. So that many times if you press Control Z, then probably you can reach there and you can do some changes. In case if you are talking about that. One minute. Guys, are you interested for this attendance part? Do you want me to tell you the attendance part? How to do this calculation? So number of class attended, 111. I can use a function count. 111 count, open bracket. I simply Control Shift left arrow. And here, close bracket, enter. Use your mathematics skill. There's no formula for that. You can use your common sense. So I use the count function 111 because I have not marked this attendance. So whoever marked the attendance, that person has used 111 for present. So I know 1 means present. So I have to count 111 how many times. So I use my common sense. I said count. So that gives total number class opened means there I can't use 1. Count I can't use because count only count numbers. So here 1 minute. 1111 no count. So some not count guys, some will be the better, not count, sorry for that. So so Abhishek has attended 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 classes Abhishek attended. Total class is count. I'll use count because all are numbers. I'll use count function here. Total class happened was 10. So I simply double click here. And I double click. This will be always 10 only. No? Percentage of attendance. I'll do equal to open bracket. Number class attended divide by total class. Close bracket, enter. I'll get this value. I get this value, I click on percentage sign, I'll get their percentage. Clear everyone? Now in case, for example, whenever Abhishek was absent, suppose there A was written. Absent means A. Many people know instead of zero, they put A. Whenever he or she was absent, instead of this, it was showing A. Can you understand this, guys? Whenever whoever is absent, the teacher, instead of putting zero, the teacher is putting A. So there I can't use count here, total class. So here I can use count A. Here I can use count A, na? Count A. Count A. So I can use count A. Close bracket, enter. I hope you understood this. Just I use the common sense. Just I use the same tool what I have told you. Suddenly one scenario is being constructed and we can use our knowledge of basic Excel. It totally works on mathematics and we can solve it to get the answer. Anyone, any doubt? Any doubt, anyone? Any question you want to ask?
No, sir. No doubt, sir.
Now, guys, see this. Suppose you use this function, rand open bracket, close bracket. So then what the rand function will do, rand function will generate a random number, guys, between 0 to 1. Okay. So I copied this, control C. Okay. Control C, I copied this. Okay. Control V. So I did that, guys. Now what happened? Because I use this function equal to rand open bracket close bracket, it has generated the random number between 0 to 1. Okay, this is what you wanted, no? Then maybe that multiplying with 100 does not come initially in your mind. Okay. Maybe multiplying with 100 does not come initially in your mind, and what you did, knowingly or unknowingly, you use that function equal to rand. You use that function equal to rand open bracket close bracket everywhere. Now, how will you multiply this with 100? How will you multiply all this value by 100? Are you understanding my problem? Yes or no? Guys, are you understanding my problem? So what is the problem I'm facing, guys? The problem I'm facing here, guys, is that this Vinay, I'll tell you how to remove the formula. To remove the formula, control C, alt ESV. Okay, so with that, you can remove the formula, Vinay. Now, guys, you see this. What Amit sir wanted. Amit sir wanted to put random number between 0 to 100 for all these 480 data. Okay, and someone told, maybe Amit sir don't know the function called rand between. So Amit sir use a function equal to rand open bracket close bracket. So what equal to rand open bracket close bracket does, it will give you a random number between 0 to 1. And you got the random number between 0 to 1. You got the random number between 0 to 1. You got that random number between 0 to 1. You got those random numbers. But once you got that random number, then you realize that I don't want the random number between 0 to 1. I want the random number between 0 to 100. So what I need to do it now, I need to multiply all this value with 100. Can you understand this? Now all this 480 data, what you're seeing, I want all these 480 numbers to be multiplied by 100. This is what I want. I don't want a number between 0 to 1. What I can do with that? So now what I can do for this? So now I hope you are understanding the problem. So now what I can do, guys, I want to multiply all this number by 100. I want to multiply all this data which is there in down with 100. So what you do, write 100 somewhere, copy that, control C. Now come here, select everything, control shift, right arrow, down arrow, select everything. Can you understand what we have done till now? Write 100, copy that, select the data on which you want to multiply 100 with. I want to multiply all this number by 100. So I wrote 100, I copied that, and then I wrote all the numbers where I want 100 to be multiplied. I selected those number. Okay, then what you do, go to home, under home, go to paste, under paste, go to paste spatial, and there can you see operation, multiply, divide, add, subtract. So if you want all the numbers to be added with 100, all the number to be divided by 100, all the number to be subtracted by 100, all the number to multiply by 100, all that you can do. Shortcut key is control C, alt E, S, M. E for elephant, S for Singapore, M for Madikeri. Alt E, S, M. Shortcut key, control C, C for Chikmangalore, control C, alt E, S, M. So press OK. So you see all these numbers got multiplied by 100. Now you want to remove the formula, you can remove the formula. Control C, copy that, Alt ESV. Now you see there's no formula. You say, sir, what you did, sir? Now, sir, this too many decimals, sir. How will I remove the decimal, sir? Marks cannot be in decimal, sir. Sir, what you did, sir? So what you, nothing to worry, guys. You see, no, here, you can reduce the decimal. You see that, increase the decimal. Can you see that? Can you see my mouse, reduce the decimal, guys. Clear, everyone. Now see that 100 become invisible. Here 100 was there, no guys? 100, can you see 100? 100 become Mr. India. 100 has become Mr. India. Can you see 100 here, guys? Is there any number here, there, guys? Is there any number here? Any number is there? No number is there. You say no number, okay? You can see any number. You see 100 was there, no? Can you see here 100 formula bar? You see 100, but 100 is not visible. This data is there, control 1, custom, general, data will get hide. You can hide the data, guys, like that. So select the data, control one, format cell, go to general, see where there is a general, see where there is general, under general, remove that. You can write double quote, space double quote, press OK. It's not happen on number or what? Yeah, it happens on number. So you can see this number is there, but it's not showing. Now it's showing. F2, it's showing. Then it's not showing. Now it's not showing. Press F2, it's showing. Now it's not showing. Press F2, it's showing. Now it's not showing. Press F2, it will show you. So you can hide a number or a formula with that. Anyone, any doubt, any question, any concern? So if you are okay, I know you don't want me to end the class, but I want to end this class. I know you people want to study for another 2 hours, but I don't want to teach you for more than another 2 hours. I want to go. I want to run away. Okay. So anyone, any doubt, any question? Okay, Narendra. Thank you, everyone. I'll see you all in next class. Till then, take care of yourself. Take care, everyone. Thank you, everyone. Please send me the attendance. Harish, everyone, please send me the attendance. All the coordinators, Kavya, please. Thank you, everyone. I'll see you all tomorrow. Thank you for your precious time, everyone. How's the Josh? Sonima, how's the Josh? Okay, great, great. Still high is there. The Josh is still high. I'm very happy. Ali Muhammad, how's the Josh? Sonima, hi. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for supporting. Thank you for keep on interacting with me. It was always being pleasure teaching you all. I really spend a lot of time with you. Thank you. Take care. Keep that spirit very high always in your life. Tasaduk, sunamat. Happy Sunday, everyone. Chalo, I'll end the class, guys. Bye, everyone. Take care. Thank you, Mubarak. Thank you, Bhagwan. Thank you, Naren. Thank you, Shreyas. Thank you, Sonika. Thank you, Kishore. Everyone, I'll see you all tomorrow. Raghu, Shreyas, Narendra. Thank you, everyone. Nagatamma, Divya, Chetra, Sonima. Thank you, everyone. Rajendra, Pooja Hegde, Kanchana, Jayashree, Pratibha. Everyone, thank you. I'll see you all next class. Till then, take care of yourself. I hope I'll see you again tomorrow. Bye, everyone.